morning to all of you. Hello? Okay. A very, very good morning to all of you. And it's such a joy and blessing that we can come as God's people to praise Him, to worship Him together. And, you know, I was just, you know, last Sunday I was speaking about, you know, the Lord keeping us as the apple of His eye and that we hide under the shadow of His wings. And I also quoted from Psalm 63, verse 7, where in the shadow of His wings, we sing for joy, yeah? So it's a place where we rejoice. And last Sunday, after church and so on in the evening, I had dinner with someone who is the daughter of the late Reverend Huang. And Reverend Huang came down from Penang, and the whole family was here taking shelter during the Second World War. And she said that when the bombs were all dropping all around, all of the children were hiding under the staircase. And on Friday night, as we were having prayer meeting, as I looked at the shape of the staircase, does it remind you of a pair of wings? And this was a place of shelter. This was a place of refuge. And the Lord literally protected all who were here. Because what I learned was that all the buildings around were bombed and demolished. But here, nothing. It was kept safe. So this building was intact. And that was an image that left an indelible impression on me, in that this is a place of refuge. And I pray it's not just in terms of a place of physical refuge, but also a spiritual refuge. And one where we can find protection, where we find safety, we can find healing and restoration. And the Lord is watching over us. Isn't that wonderful? That He's keeping us as the apple of His eye, and that we are hiding in the shadow of His wings. Amen. Hallelujah. The Lord be with you. And let's say together the colic for purity. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, so that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, the first commandment is this: the Lord our God is the only Lord. And you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this: love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. Amen. Lord, have mercy upon us and write all these laws in our hearts. Scriptures remind us that God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. So let us take a few moments to reflect on the events of the past week. And if there's anything that we need to set right before the Lord, may we do so now as we confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all people. Let us pray. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our fellow men in thought, in word, and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Receive now the words of absolution. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. I'd like now to invite the worship team to lead us in a time of praise and worship. Let's warmly welcome Marcus and his team. Yeah?
Hallelujah. May I invite all to stand. Let's praise the Lord because our Lord is almighty. And I don't know about you, but you might have brought along your worries and anxieties. That could be a problem that you are facing in this coming week or even this season of your life. Just picture right now that the God of the universe, not just the God of Holy Trinity Church or the God of the island of Singapore, God of the universe is standing behind you and beside you. And we have that image as we face whatever anxieties or troubles that you have ahead. And the troubles are still there, but you know who is beside you. Let's worship the Lord. The Lord reigns. The Lord reigns. The Lord reigns. The Lord reigns. Let the earth rejoice. Let the earth rejoice. Let the earth rejoice. Let the presence of the Lord, let the presence of the Lord, let's clap our hands. The Lord reigns, the Lord reigns, the Lord reigns. Let the earth rejoice, let the earth rejoice, let the earth rejoice, let the people be God reigns, that our God reigns, that our God reigns. Hallelujah, Lord. You reign, Lord. I will call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from my enemies. Upon the Lord, I will call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from my enemies. I will call upon the Lord. The Lord lives. The Lord. Rock, and let the God of my salvation be exalted. The Lord liveth, and blessed be my rock, and let the God of my salvation be exalted. I will call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised. The Lord lives. The Lord lives.
and let the God of my salvation be exalted. The Lord liveth, and blessed be my rock, and let the God of my salvation be exalted. The Lord liveth, and blessed be my rock, and let the God of my salvation be exalted. The Lord liveth, and blessed be my rock, and let the God of my salvation be exalted.
The Lord lives.
The Lord liveth, and blessed be my rock, and let the God of my salvation be exalted. The Lord liveth, and blessed be my rock, and let the God of my salvation be exalted.
Hallelujah, Lord. Let's give God a clap offering. Hallelujah. Lord, as we come to you, Lord, we want to rejoice. We want to rejoice even in our troubles. We want to rejoice because we are in the shadows of your wings, Lord. Lord, we want to come to you today. We just want to lay aside all our troubles, all our anxieties at your feet. Come and fill us with your Holy Spirit. Fill us with your power and your might. That though we face the troubles ahead, but we know that we have a God that's bigger than the troubles. May I invite Anne to sing this song for us as she ministers to us. Hearts to the Lord.
Desire and I love.
Before the Lord and know that He is God. Let's take joy to be in the presence of the Lord. I will come and bow down at your feet, Lord Jesus. In your presence is fullness of joy. There is nothing, there is no one who compares with. I take pleasure in worshiping you, Lord. Heaven is your throne, and the earth is your footstool. Jesus, I come to bow down at your feet. To worship before you in your presence, my joy is complete. I will come and bow down at your feet, Lord Jesus. In your presence is fullness of joy. There is nothing, there is no one who compares with you. I take pleasure in worshiping you, Lord. Heaven. Your feet, Lord Jesus, in your presence is fullness of joy. There is nothing, there is no one who compares with you. I take pleasure in worshiping you, Lord. of God has reached for me and pulled me from a raging sea, and I am safe on this solid ground. The Lord is my salvation. I will not fear when darkness falls. His strength will help me scale this walls. I'll see the dawn of the rising sun. The Lord is my salvation.
Let's proclaim.
Each promise of His word. When winter fades, I know spring will come. The Lord is my salvation. In times of waiting, times of need, when I know loss, when I am, my salvation. Who is like the Lord our God, strong to save, faithful in love. My debt is paid and the victory won. The Lord is my salvation.
Lord, glory be to God the Father, glory be to God the Son, glory be to God the Spirit. The Lord is our salvation. Glory be to God.
And all the people of God say, Amen. The Lord is our salvation. Hallelujah. You may be seated for the scripture reading. The first reading is from Acts chapter 2, verses 42 to 47, Acts chapter 2. And they devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and the fellowship, to the breaking of bread and the prayers. And awe came upon every soul, and many wonders and signs were being done through the apostles. And all who believed were together and had all things in common. And they were selling their possessions and belongings and distributing the proceeds to all as any had need. And day by day, attending the temple together and breaking bread in their homes, they received their food with glad and generous hearts, praising God and having favor with all the people. And the Lord added to their number day by day those who were being saved. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Second scripture reading for today is taken from Psalm chapter 18, verses 1 to 50. To the choir master, a psalm of David, the servant of the Lord, who addressed the words of this song to the Lord on the day when the Lord delivered him from the hand of all his enemies and from the hand of Saul. He said, I love you, O Lord, my strength. The Lord is my rock and my fortress and my deliverer, my God, my rock in whom I take refuge, my shield and the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. I call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised, and I am saved from my enemies. The cords of death encompassed me. The torrents of destruction assailed me. The cords of Sheol entangled me. The snares of death confronted me. In my distress, I called upon the Lord. To my God, I cried for help. From his temple, he heard my voice, and my cry to him reached his ears. Then the earth reeled and rocked. The foundations also of the mountains trembled and quaked, because he was angry. Smoke went up from his nostrils, and devouring fire from his mouth, glowing coals flamed forth from him. He bowed the heavens and came down. Thick darkness was under his feet. He rode on a cherub and flew. He came swiftly on the wings of the wind. He made darkness his covering, his canopy around him, thick clouds dark with water. Out of the brightness before him, hailstones and coals of fire broke through his clouds. The Lord also thundered in the heavens, and the Most High uttered his voice, hailstones and coals of fire. And he sent out his arrows and scattered them. He flashed forth lightnings and routed them. Then the channels of the sea were seen, and the foundations of the world were laid bare at your rebuke, O Lord, at the blast of the breath of your nostrils. He sent from on high, he took me. He drew me out of many waters. He rescued me from a strong enemy and from those who hated me, for they were too mighty for me. They confronted me in the day of my calamity, but the Lord was my support. He brought me out into a broad place. He rescued me because he delighted in me. The Lord dealt with me according to my righteousness, according to the cleanness of the hands he rewarded me. For I have kept the ways of the Lord and have not wickedly departed from my God. For all his rules were before me, and his statutes I did not put away from me. I was blameless before him, and I kept myself from my guilt. So the Lord has rewarded me according to my righteousness, according to the cleanness of my hands in his sight. With the merciful, you show yourself merciful. With the blameless man, you show yourself blameless. With the purified, you show yourself pure. And with the crooked, you make yourself seem tortuous. For you save a humble people, but the haughty eyes you bring down. For it is you who light my lamp. The Lord my God lightens my darkness. For by you I can run against a troop, and by my God I can leap over a wall. This God, his way is perfect. The word of the Lord proves true. He's a shield for all those who take refuge in him. For who is God but the Lord? And who is a rock except our God? The God who equipped me with strength and made my way blameless. He made my feet like the feet of a deer and set me secure on the heights. He trains my hands for war so that my arms can bend a bow of bronze. You have given me the shield of your salvation, and your right hand supported me, and your gentleness made me great. You gave a wide place for my steps under me, and my feet did not slip. I pursued my enemies and overtook them, and did not turn back till they were consumed. I thrust them through so that they were not able to rise. They fell under my feet. For you equipped me with strength for the battle. You made those who rise against me sink under me. You made my enemies turn their backs to me, and those who hated me I destroyed. They cried for help, but there was none to save. They cried to the Lord, but he did not listen, answer them. I beat them fine as dust before the wind. I cast them out like the mire on the streets. You delivered me from strife with the people. You made me the head of the nations. People whom I had not known served me. As soon as they heard of me, they obeyed me. Foreigners came cringing to me. Foreigners lost heart and came trembling out of their fortresses. The Lord lives, and blessed be my rock. Exalted be the God of my salvation, the God who gave me vengeance and subdued peoples under me, who rescued me from my enemies. Yes, you exalted me above those who rose against me. You delivered me from the men of violence. For this I will praise you, O Lord, among the nations, and sing to your name. Great salvation he brings to his king, and shows steadfast love to his anointed, to David and his offspring forever. This is the word of the Lord.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Let us bow our heads and come to our Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this morning that you have gathered us. We thank you that, Lord, we are able to listen to your voice and to study your word. So help us, Lord, to understand your word. Through your Holy Spirit, stir our hearts and minister to us. Use my mouth to speak forth your word, Lord. And that, Lord, your Holy Spirit to grant to us wisdom and understanding, that, Lord, we are able to apply your word to our daily living, and that, Lord, we can live to your work, to your praise and glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, you have to pardon me that I have to keep my mask on. You know, for the last 2 weeks, I have fallen ill. Doctors say I caught the flu bug. Well, some of you may say, hey, just a flu bug, no big deal, right? So that was what I thought too. Well, at first it was a fever and cough. The initial onset two Mondays ago had me sleeping the whole day, much like what when I first caught COVID-19. And by the end of the week, I was much better. Then last Monday, my throat got worse. It became so sore, and I had a lot of yellowish phlegm, and some came out red as well. So this got me worried, and I called for help, requesting prayers and crying out to God, save me from this sickness. Well, I suppose it's no fun being sick for 2 weeks, right? And praise God, I am well, at least for now. It is just the cough and no fever. So I have to put my mask on just in case I cough, right? Well, this is just a quick little testimony to encourage you that our God, the Lord who created the heavens and the earth and everything in it, including you and I, do continue to save us from our adversary. In my case, the flu bug. Our passage today is a powerful testimony to God's power and faithfulness in delivering his people from adversity. David, the author of the Psalm, whose experience of distress and danger in all of his life serves as a reminder of the importance of trust in God's protection and deliverance. And I believe this psalm is a powerful declaration of faith and trust in God's power and protection. So today, I want to invite you to join me in exploring this psalm and discovering what it means to trust in God. No matter what we may be facing, we can trust God, trust in God's protection and deliverance. and that He is always ready to hear our cries for help and respond to our needs. So there are 3 points this morning to remind us of who the Lord is for us. First, the Lord our rock. Second, the Lord our deliverer. And third, the Lord our Savior. Let us look at the first point, the Lord our rock. In verses 1 to 3, we see David describing God as his rock. Out of his deep love for God, he declares, "The Lord is my rock and my fortress, my God, my rock." And in verse 31, if you look it down your Bible, he says, "Who is a rock except our God?" And in verse 46, "The Lord lives, and blessed be my rock." Such is the imagery that David used to describe God. And I was just wondering, how would you describe God? What sort of an image you would come up with about God, who God is to you? So, what does God, our rock, signify? The metaphor of God as a rock and fortress speaks to our deep-seated need for security and protection, which is a fundamental aspect of our human experience, right? And I believe this need is particularly relevant in today's world, although not necessarily unique for our time. You see, we face a variety of threats and challenges that can leave us feeling vulnerable, exposed, be it physically, mentally, emotionally, and whether you know it or not, even spiritually. For example, many people today feel a sense of insecurity and fear due to the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic. All right, if you have seen the news, and I'm sure many of your people or your friends, your relatives who have told you, "Hey, do you know that COVID-19 in Singapore, the number of cases has gone up?" Yeah, I'm sure you do. You know, just like many people, I also continue to wear my mask while on public transport. The virus, as we all know, has disrupted many lives, our lives, in countless ways, leaving many people uncertain about the future. Loss of jobs, company has to close down, lost jobs, no finances, and everything of our life, our lifestyle, are being disrupted. And in times like this, the metaphor of God as a rock and fortress can provide comfort and assurance, reminding us that we are not alone, and that there is a source of strength and protection available to us, and that is God, our Creator. And similarly, many people today feel a sense of insecurity and fear due to the political and social instability. Conflict in Ukraine, the recent Sudan war, and even the race to show off military power in the Taiwan Straits. Furthermore, the economic uncertainty see many tech companies cut jobs. Even big banks thought to be very stable has collapsed. And of course, the other global issues or challenges like food security and climate change. You know, the metaphor of God as rock and fortress can provide comfort and reassurance in these situations, reminding us that there is a source of stability and security that is greater than any human institution or power. And then that is the Almighty God. Ultimately, God as a rock and fortress reminds us that our need for security and protection It's not simply just a matter of physical safety, but it also encompasses our emotional, spiritual, and psychological well-being. It calls us to place our trust in God as the ultimate source of strength and protection, and to find our security and peace in His unfailing love and care. And I believe that is why David say, "I love you, O Lord, my strength." And I believe you have gone through your own experiences of how God has been that rock and fortress for you. You too will say, "I love you, Lord, my strength." This brings us to the next point. The Lord, our deliverer. In this section of the psalm from verse 4 to verse 19, we see David describe his situation. His life is on the line. His desperate cry to God for help. God, being the faithful God, always responds to our cry for help. And David is sure of that. Look at verse 6. He said, "In my distress, I called upon the Lord. To my God, I cried for help. From his temple, he heard my voice, and my cry to him reached his ears." These statements are David's testimony to God's faithfulness. He is a God who hears the cries of his people and delivers them from their troubles. In Psalms 34, verses 4 to 7, another praise song by David, when he drove Abimelech away, expressed this same confidence he had in God. And he says, "I sought the Lord and he answered me and delivered me from my fears. Those who look to him are radiant and their faces shall never be ashamed. This poor man cried and the Lord heard him and saved him out of all his troubles. The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him and delivers them." How wonderful that is. As God's children, when we call out to our Lord, he hears our cries and he comes to our rescues. Let's look one in verses 7 to 19. We see God's powerful response where David described how God responded to his cry for help. With great power and might, including what? Earthquakes, thunderstorms, and God rescued him from his enemies. Again, we see David uses vivid images to describe God's power and might. For example, he writes, "The Lord thundered in the heavens. The Most High uttered his voice." Now, that sounds like thunderstorms and all, right? "And he parted the heavens and came down. Dark clouds were under his feet." These images convey the idea of a God who is powerful, God who is majestic, and a God who is awe-inspiring. Although it seems God is like a very fierce God since he's so powerful and mighty, despite of this great power, listen to what David emphasized. He says, "God is also faithful and loving towards his people." This is what he writes. He says, "As for God, his way is perfect. The Lord's word is flawless. He shields all who take refuge in him. And he is a shield for all who take refuge in him." And all these passages convey the idea of a God who is trustworthy, who is dependable, and he is always faithful to his promises to his people, because all his people are the apple of his eyes. Furthermore, we see David celebrate God's role as a deliverer here through verses 17 to 18. He writes, "He rescued me from my strong enemy and from those who hated me, for they were too mighty for me. They confronted me in the day of my calamity. But the Lord was my support. He brought me out into a broad place. He rescued me because He delighted in me. David is the apple of God's eyes. And these passages emphasize God's ability to save His people from danger and trouble and to bring them into a place of safety and freedom. Brothers and sisters, I may not know what you are going through right now in this stage of your life, but God knows. And whatever challenges or difficulties you may be facing, I want you to know this. God is with you. And He is more than able to help you. He is our refuge in times of trouble. There is no problem too big that God cannot solve. No mountain so big that He cannot move it. And the best of all, we can take shelter under His wings. So put your trust in God. Seek Him with all your heart, and He will answer you. Draw near to Him, and He will draw near to you. And remember that even in the darkest of times, God's light will shine through and bring you hope and peace. Because our God is our Savior. This brings us to the next point, the Lord our Savior. When you look at this last section from verses 20 to 50, right? It's a bit long, right? But the idea behind all these verses can be said to be a reiteration of God's salvation to David. How God has enabled David to overcome his situation, to overcome his enemies. And this was because he put his faith in a perfect God. Let's look at verse 20 to 24. By faith, David had kept his integrity before God. This deliverance was because God was rewarding David for his cleanness. Right, his cleanness of life. And that means his life. A cleanness of his hands. That means his life. And David attested that he had not turned away from God. And he walked in God's ways. He obeyed God's law and decrees. And he kept himself from sin. And I believe God honored his obedient servant. And this is what we see in the victories that David had over his enemies and over all the situations that he were in. Although we all know there was a time when David sinned against God, but David repented. And after which, he wrote Psalm 51. And God forgave him and restored his promises to David. And this attests to the Lord's nature in dealing with his people, you and I. God's ways are always just. Look at verse 25 to 30. David understood God rewards people according to their inner character. Faithfulness to the faithful, blamelessness to the blameless, purity to the pure, but shrewdness to the crooked. God's dealings are always just because our God is a perfect God. And in subsequent verses from 31 to 50, we see again, David said God was his rock and described how God prepared him for battle, giving him strength, agility, and efficiency, and how God gave him victory over his enemies, pursuing, crushing, and destroying them, and also how God gave him rule over all other nations. You know, the predominant idea throughout these verses is that David attributed every ability and victory to the Lord, not himself. Everything he had done and everything he now enjoyed was due to the Lord's blessing. And that led David to declare in verse 46, "The Lord lives, and blessed be my rock, and exalted be the God of my salvation." Just now we sang the song, "The Lord is my salvation." This expressed who God is to us, and He is our Savior. As His rock, God was His source of safety and security. This is David, who always addresses God as his rock. The Lord had given David great victories and has shown his loyal love to his anointed servant David. And God would also give victory to David's descendants. Brothers and sisters, David has described how God saved him from his enemies and from the hands of death. He praises God for delivering him from the perilous situation and providing him with the strength and protection he needed to overcome his foes. This is the wonderful salvation of God to him. And I believe we can relate to this theme of salvation on a deeper level through our faith in Jesus Christ. Through his death and resurrection, Jesus has provided us with the ultimate salvation from sin and death. When we put our faith in Jesus, we are saved from the penalty of our sins and are reconciled to God. Like David, we too can praise God for his deliverance and his faithfulness in providing us with the salvation we so desperately needed. We can trust in his power and protection, knowing that he has already overcome the world through Jesus. In summary, Psalm 18 is a powerful testimony to God's power and faithfulness in delivering his people from adversity. David's experiences of distress and danger serve as a reminder to the importance of trust in God's protection and deliverance. Through vivid imagery and powerful language, David highlights God as our rock, our deliverer, and our Savior, and points us towards the ultimate salvation we have in Jesus Christ. I believe you also face struggles in one way or another, and that can leave you feeling overwhelmed and helpless. Friends, brothers and sisters, may this psalm remind you that we can trust in God's protection and deliverance, and that He is always ready to hear our cries for help and respond to our needs. As we continue to trust in God and His saving grace, we can have confidence that He will always be there to provide us with the strength and protection we need to overcome our challenges and to live out our faith to the fullest. You know, when you think about it, there are countless examples of how God's salvation has transformed the lives of believers throughout history and continues to do so today. For example, the Apostle Paul. Before his conversion, Paul was a fierce persecutor of Christians. But when he encountered the risen Christ on the road to Damascus, he was radically transformed. He became a devoted follower of Jesus, and his life was never the same again. He went on to become one of the most influential Christian leaders in history, spreading the gospel to the Gentiles, which is why we have the most magnificent church architecture all over Europe today. And Paul wrote many of the letters that make up the New Testament, which we are using to encourage us to live a Christ-like life. St. Augustine. You know, Augustine was a renowned philosopher and rhetorician in the late Roman Empire. He too struggled with questions about meaning of life and the existence of evil. And through his study of the Bible and encounters with Christian leaders, he eventually came to faith in Jesus. His life was transformed, and he went on to become one of the most influential theologians in Christian history. What about someone from our day, and he was still alive? Nick Vujicic. Nick Vujicic was born without arms or legs, and he struggled with feelings of hopelessness and despair as a young man. And I'm sure you can imagine no one, perhaps, maybe as despair as him, having no arms and legs. But through his faith in Christ, he found hope and purpose. For all those who do not know, he's living well in the sense he has a full family, he has children, he has a wife. The world sharing his story and his faith, inspiring millions of people with his message of hope and perseverance. You know, these are just a few examples of how God's salvation has transformed the lives of people who became believers. No matter who we are or what we have been through, God's salvation is available to us. And it has the power to transform our lives in ways we never thought possible. Friends, do you want to have your life transformed and live in peace and security? God is inviting you to receive this free gift because He loves you. And now, if you have not yet put your faith in Jesus, I encourage you to do so today. It is through Him that we can find true peace and security in this life and in the life to come. I want to invite you to respond to God's word today. Can I invite all of us to close our eyes and bow our heads? I want to invite those of you who have never put your faith in Jesus as your Savior to follow me in saying this prayer. You can repeat after me. Dear God, I want you to be my rock, my deliverer, and Savior. I confess that I am a sinner and in need of your forgiveness. I believe that Jesus died on the cross for my sins and rose from the dead. I turn away from my sin and ask for your forgiveness. I trust in Jesus as my Savior. And Lord, thank you for saving me and giving me eternal life. I look forward to a transformed life in Jesus. Amen. Now we continue in this posture of prayer. And I want to invite those who are already a believer in Jesus. And you are currently facing struggles and difficulties in life. I want you to turn to God for protection and deliverance. Remember, brothers and sisters, the Lord is your rock, your deliverer, and your Savior. and He is always faithful to His promises. You can pray this prayer with me. Dear God, I am facing difficult circumstances in my life, and I need Your help. I trust in You as my rock, my deliverer, and my Savior. I ask for Your protection and deliverance. Help me to trust in Your power and faithfulness, and to follow Your leading in my life. Thank You for Your love and grace towards me. In Jesus' name, amen. Let us bow our head, and I just want to pray for all of us as you have heard the word of the Lord coming to us, telling us to trust in Him, to continue to put our faith in Him, because He is the rock. He is our rock, personally to each and every one of us. And He is the deliverer. He is our Savior. Heavenly Father, we thank You that, Lord, You are our Savior, our Deliverer, and our Rock. We thank You that, Lord, through Your word, we see how You have carried David through his life. And as we reflect upon our own lives, whether we are young or we are old, whether we have lived this life in the young age that we are now, or it seems to be the sunset age that we are in. Lord, there are many times that we do not know where to turn to when we face adversity. We thank You for Your word of encouragement to Your servant David, that how he continues to put his trust in You. Help us, Lord, we want to do the same. We want to put our trust in You. And for those of us who are facing some challenges right now, maybe we do not know some bondage that is binding us and is hindering us from coming to You. Lord, in the powerful name of Yours, we declare victory over this challenge. We declare victory over this bondage. Deliver us, Lord, from our difficulties. In the situation that we feel there is no hope, we have forgotten that You are our rock. You are our hope. You are the one who grant to us salvation by Your grace. Help us to continue to cling on to You, to put our faith in this rock, the rock of our salvation. We thank You, Father, for hearing our prayers. We thank You, Lord, for loving us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Brothers and sisters, may I invite you to rise as we continue to trust in our God as the rock of our salvation. The grace of God has reached for me and pull me forward.
from a raging sea. And I am safe on this solid ground. The Lord is my salvation. I will not fear when darkness falls. His strength will help me scale this wall. I'll see the dawn of the rising sun. The Lord is my salvation.
Let's proclaim.
My dad is
Let us read the Apostles' Creed together. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. Sorry. The Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead, and live in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. The collect for fourth Sunday of Easter, altogether. Almighty God, whose Son Jesus Christ is the resurrection and the life of all who put their trust in him, raise us, we pray, for the death of sin to the life of righteousness, that we may seek the things which are above, where he reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The prayer sits together. Father God, thank you that you are present with me. Even right now, I want to become more aware of your presence in my life. You are refuge, my protector. Restore my joy and help me live in the light of your grace and mercy. In difficult times, keep me as the apple of your eye. Hide me in the shadow of your wings. In Jesus' precious name. Amen. Father, we want to thank you for giving us this time that you can stand the gap to intercede for your church, for our nation, Singapore, for the world. Father, as we quieten our hearts before you, we want to make our cry out to you for the world. As John 16:33 says, in the world you will have tribulation, but take heart, I've overcome the world. Thank you, Father God, for your assurance that you have overcome the world. Our Lord Jesus calls all, especially brothers and sisters in Christ, to put their hope in him, especially in the midst of all that assault and assail our peace and security. Pray that may those living in war-torn nations, in places where there is widespread economic poverty, illness, and disease, in part of the world suffering famine or drought, pray, Father God, for they may find hope, comfort, and peace in the Lord. May those who are able to be led to respond in ways that would elevate, resolve, heal, and restore those who are suffering and those who are in need. Pray that in particular, God, we pray that those, especially those in Ukraine and Sudan, who continue to face much hardship and uncertainty, may they find healing in God's love and care and their way to everlasting peace in Jesus Christ, our Savior of the world. Thank you, Father God. Father God, at this point of time, we want to uphold our nation, Singapore. Father, we pray for God's guidance upon those in authority and governing in formulating policies. Pray that they may be led to direct this nation in the ways of justice and of peace, and that the well-being and needs of all people in Singapore be looked after and cared for. We pray, God, faithful people, be eager and ready to share the good news of Jesus Christ to all in anticipation of his return. Thank you, Father God. Father, we will surrender our Diocese of Singapore unto you. want to pray for God's blessing be upon all the clergy, staff, and workers, especially for St. James Church, O Lord. May the Lord lead and guide them in their shepherding and building up the faith of their parishioners. May their parishioners be empowered by the Holy Spirit and be equipped for every good work to serve the Lord and advance His kingdom here on earth. Thank you, Father God. Father, we surrender Holy Trinity Church, our family came to you on the 11th to 14th of June. Father, we thank you for the good response, the good numbers we have signed up for this camp, O Lord. We pray for the camp committee in the planning and organization to have the Lord's strength, wisdom, and favor upon them. Pray that the camp be one that bring about spiritual renewal and refreshment and strengthens our fellowship. Pray that for this camp, O Lord, all the participants will have a fruitful time together and be able to communicate with one another, to edify one another too, Lord. Thank you, Father. Father, when we commit the confirmation candidates to you from the 7th to 28th of May as they attend their classes, pray for the Lord's guidance and anointing be upon all the teachers, that as they prepare and teach the confirmation classes, pray that the participants be fully engaged and learn what it means to be a disciple of Jesus. Pray also that the power of the Holy Spirit lead and guide the sessions so that they would know God better and be drawn closer to Him. Thank you, Father. Congregation, let's spend a moment of quietness and commit the names of those who we know are suffering in body, mind, or spirit in prayer. Psalms 23, verse 4 and 5 recorded, "Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemy. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows." Father, we thank you for your promises. Even when we go through in difficult times, Lord, you are always be with us. Thank you, Father God, for hearing our prayer. We pray all this in the mighty name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We ask and pray. Amen.
Thank you. Once again, a very warm welcome to all of you. Is there anyone who is here worshiping with us for the first time today? Any visitor, a newcomer? Everybody is here before? Okay, good. Yep, that's no worries. Just a quick run through the some of the announcements. The rest can be found on your bulletins. The first is regarding cell leaders meeting. Okay. 7th of May, which is next Sunday, at 1:30 p.m. In Kindness Room. So all who are cell leaders and assistants, please kindly take note. And then there's English Congregation Committee meeting. This is the first meeting after the AGM. Thank the Lord for the newly composed committee. 13th of May at 2 p.m. in the conference room also. Just want to ask for your prayers also, yeah? And there's going to be a parish combined community services Sunday worship service here, 14th of May at 10 o'clock. So there's going to just be one service that day on the 14th. So please kindly take note that Dr. Low from SAMH is going to come and speak. And on that same day, on Sunday the 14th, we're going to have the English Congregation Leaders Gathering. So all of you who are involved in ministry, cell group, leaders, Sunday school teachers, you're expected to attend this meeting. Please kindly register so that we can do the necessary in terms of food catering and so on. Yeah. Confirmation classes, for those who are seeking confirmation, quite a number of you this time, please kindly take note of the dates and the timings. And if you're 14 and above, you can be confirmed. Yeah. So May 7th, 2:30 p.m., because of the various meetings, on the 14th as well at 3 p.m., and 21st and 28th at 1:30 p.m. at the Level 4 conference room. Our confirmation service is scheduled for the 4th of June this year. Next, for those who are interested, obviously, in studying the Word, and in particular, books of the Bible, well, this is something I would commend to you. It's going to be a guided study course on the book of Joshua conducted by Reverend Dr. So. And the first group session will be held here in the conference room on the 9th of May, Tuesday night, 7:30 p.m. The course and registration details are in your bulletin. And for those of you who want to discover some of the nuggets about living the victorious Christian life, well, this is one of those that will be, I would commend to you. Yeah. Next slide. Today is the last day for you all to sign up for the church camp. So those of you who have still not yet done so and are wondering, well, wonder no more. Just sign up downstairs after the service and do so with payment as well. And just commend that to you. Next slide. Those of you who have signed up, we need to verify your details, your passport details, personal details. This will enable the church camp committee to do the necessary in terms of the hotel registrations and various other logistical arrangements. And so please kindly help us in account to do so with the camp committee members. You can do that downstairs as well. Next slide. Tithes and offerings, the usual manner, through the electronic means. But we'll also be taking a physical collection after this. Shall we now stand together for the peace? But before that, just a quick note. Bishop Low is in Batam to conduct confirmation. So please kindly keep him in prayer. And he and I will be also on leave for a period of time. Deborah and I are traveling to Malaysia to visit her auntie, as well as to take some time to pray up in the OMF guest house in Cameron Highlands. So please pray for us. Of course, we will take some other excursions along the way and, you know, visit eating places in Ipoh, in KL, so on and so forth, okay? It's a time for a little break for us as well. So please do keep us in your kind prayers. Next week, we'll have Reverend Dino, who will come and preach God's word to us. So you're not without a shepherd. You can laugh. Okay, I think you're all tired. All right. Let us say these words together. But before we do that, as in our usual manner, which I would like to do, is to have a quick look around. Who you're sharing the peace with, you know, and smile. Let's say these words together. We are the body of Christ. In the one spirit, we were all baptized in the one body. Let us then pursue all that makes for peace and builds up our common life. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Let's share the peace of Christ one another. We sing together now the offertory song, I Bow My Knee.
Let's remain standing. I bow my knee before your throne. I know my life is not my own. I offer up a song of praise to bring you pleasure, Lord. I seek the giver, not the gift. My heart's desire is to above all earthly kings. Hallelujah.
The God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the eternal covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.
Let's put our hope and trust in the Lord.
What is our hope in life and death? Christ alone, Christ alone. What is our only confidence? That our souls to Him belong, who holds our days within His hands. What comes apart from His command, and what will keep us to the end? The love of Christ in which we stand. Our hope in life and death. What truth can come the troubled soul? God is good, God is good. And is His grace and goodness known? In our great Redeemer's blood, who holds our faith when fears arise, who stands above the stormy trial, who sends the waves that bring us nigh unto the shore, the rock of Christ. Oh, sing hallelujah, our hope springs eternal. Christ, our hope in life and death. Unto the grave, what shall we sing? Christ, He lives, Christ, He lives. And what we want will heaven bring. Everlasting life with Him.
And we will rise,
and we will rise. The Lord, then sin and death will be destroyed, and we will feast in endless joy when Christ is ours forevermore. Oh, sing hallelujah, our hope springs eternal. Now whenever we confess Christ our hope in life and death.
Oh, sing hallelujah.
Oh, sing hallelujah. Our hope springs eternal. Oh, sing hallelujah. Now and ever we confess Christ our hope in life and death. Now and ever we confess Christ our hope in life and death.
The service is over. We'll see you next week.